Hi friends, welcome to my channel Agri-Bio-Tech. I am Ganesh Thakur. I am back with one more video. This video is on introduction and principles of biotechnology. So first, let's see introduction of biotechnology. The term biotechnology is made by two different words, that is biology and technology. Carl Ehrke is regarded as father of term biotechnology. He was a Hungarian agricultural engineer who coined the term biotechnology in 1919. Now, the first question will come in your mind that what is biotechnology? So, let's go back some years ago. Before, when we buy tomato, there is a 60% chance that tomato will have worm inside or rotten from inside. How did it happen that today's tomato don't have worm inside? It's somehow evolution, but specifically biotechnology. Biotechnology is the science that is based on biology. So, let's see definition of biotechnology. Biotechnology is the use of living organisms to develop or make products. It is the technology that involves the use of living organisms to develop products for benefits of mankind. Now, let's see principles of biotechnology. Modern biotechnology started with two crucial technologies, genetic engineering and chemical engineering. So, first one is genetic engineering. Genetic engineering is to modify the organisms by changing its genetic material. It includes the recombinant DNA technology. So, what is recombinant DNA technology? Recombinant DNA is defined as any DNA which is composed of sequences derived from different sources. So, let's see major steps involved in this technique. The cell having desired DNA molecules are separated and gene of interest is isolated. This DNA is then cleaved into many fragments by restriction enzyme. The DNA thus isolated is called passenger or donor DNA. After that, a suitable vector, that is plasmid of bacteria, is isolated. Then, donor DNA is inserted into this plasmid vector. This modified DNA or plasmid is now called recombinant DNA or recombinant plasmid. This recombinant DNA formed is to be introduced into the host cell. This host cell can be a bacterium or yeast cell. And methods used for introduction are transformation, transduction, and vectorless gene transfer. Then, in the host cell, this recombinant DNA can replicate and form clones. Then, bacterial cells with recombinant DNA are selected and isolated from bacteria population, either by immunological method or by nucleic acid hybridization method and blue-white screening, etc. Now, second principle is chemical engineering. Due to modern biotechnology, pharmaceutical industries reached to the peak point. This application resulted in many biological products, both in terms of quality and quantity. It improved the methods of manufacturing, storage, and maintenance. Antibiotics, enzymes, vaccines, etc. are few examples. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and share our channel Agri-Bio-Tech. Thank you.